Ready for a check of our weather and traffic.
The heat. It's what we've been talking about all week.
On.
Hi, Jill.
Yes.
And on and on and on.
Continuing. Look at that. 80 degrees right now. You see that on the bottom of your screen? Yeah, and that's the actual temperature here for New York City. Also for Hoboken, still very warm here. Stamford, that is, at 76. 77 in Asbury Park. And also want to point out your dew points. Quite impressive. We're in the 70s. 75 Belmar, New York City at 71. So, yes, unfortunately, that moisture is in the air, that high humidity feeling like. And, yes, unfortunately, it is very oppressive out there. So your feel like temperatures today will be 96 in the city, 98 in Rumson, Edgewater at 97 degrees. And again, this will not last. Though we do have some relief in sight for the weekend. Want to point that out. And keep in mind your future cast. Take a look. It's going to feel 20 degrees cooler tomorrow. Yeah, 78 for New York. Tomorrow will be your future cast temperature. 75 Newburgh, 73 at Islip. Get out that beach chair. Get out that bike because it will be a beautiful day, even though there's some showers involved. But temperature wise, definitely much better. And again, we'll enjoy that little period of relief. As far as the roads, LIE, we have a full closure right now. Eastbound overturned truck here at Hampton Boulevard, exit 30, 32. Also reports of a fire here as well. So definitely already very heavy delays there on the LIE itself. Stick with the Grand Central. Here's the live look, and LaGuardia Airport's quiet through this area. And again, we'll keep you posted throughout the morning when this crash on the LIE does clear, because that will affect your morning commute. Again, although it is on the eastbound side, westbound, you are still delay-free through the area. Vanessa and John, back to you.
All right, Jill, thank you so much. Well, Governor Kathy Hochul introducing her pick for lieutenant governor. Hear what State Senator Brian Benjamin is promising to do for New Yorkers.
Plus, the NYPD releasing new video showing a gunman opening fire in a crowded Staten Island hair salon. It's a shocking crime, and we'll have the details when we come back.